for welcoming us back to the land of Delagrange. Dear presidents of the FDA, I remember being your gallant teacher, and you were such a hard-working student that I am not surprised that you went this far in your life. Respected chairwoman, thanks for leading this debate with such charisma. Delegates, bellwoman, and timekeeper, thanks for your valuable precision. Impartial jury, may your decision be guided with great wisdom. My dear beloved family, Connor, Kate, Colleen, and what's your name already? Carrie. Kids, lazy kids of today's youth that now compose the government. Good morning. I am Colin Murphy, the eldest of the family. I am so old, people sometimes say I'm on the verge of fossilization. Back in my days, we weren't into all this fancy debate stuff. If there were an argument at the pub, we would just settle this the good old way. The one who won the fight won the argument. But apparently, this essential aspect of Irish culture isn't allowed in embassies. So, I have to start instead. Now, we're not saying that you have to work more, but working less, as tempting as it may be, is not the solution. Imagine if we worked less in these debates. We wouldn't have a single chance against this paradoxically hardworking government.
You said good morning. Would that be considered a Freudian slip because you work so much they don't really know what time of day it is anymore?
So imagine if we were less in this debate, we wouldn't have a single chance against this paradoxically hardworking government. Speaking of the government, your second speaker said that her timetable was divided by two because there were more doctors. So maybe you as an individual worked less, but in total, there were no less work. You talked about the educational system and the teachers, and it's not about working less, it's about changing the system. And there are amazing teachers that do everything they can and they work to change the system, like Mrs. Montessori, for example. Then you talked about breathing. According to you, we say that breathing is work, but no, because breathing is an automatic reflex. Plus, it can be work if you have asthma. Now, I'd like to talk about some of the points we apparently disagreed on. You said that work was equal to suffering. You talked about the Latin etymology. So first, congratulations, you must have worked a lot to learn Latin. Words have a story, and words evolved, and the woman died a long time ago already. And not because it came from a word in suffering, means that today it is suffering. Yeah. Another point...
Yes. Do you then consider that everything is work?
No, it's something that demands repeated effort is work.
Here.
And we didn't agree on something. You said that less work would lead to happiness.
When
I don't mention. No, thank you. So that means that according to you, the less you work, the happier you are. So then, tell me, are unemployed people happier? My son was unemployed for so much time, and I can tell you he was not happy. No, thank you. It's even the opposite. It's work that can lead you to happiness. We already said before that struggle led to happiness. And struggle is related to work. So yes, work can lead to happiness. So, my granddaughter Pauline showed the importance of work for your future and for yourself. And that's why I immigrated 8 years ago. My daughter-in-law, Kate, exposed the importance of work to develop and maintain relationships. That's what I did my whole life with my now deceased wife. And my son Connor proved the importance of work to build a better society. And that is why I fight every day for the conservation of garbage. Now, we may agree at least on something. Maybe spending less time in an office would not be so bad, but the definition of work goes beyond having a job. Work, real work, is essential for yourself, for your link with others, for society, and for our future. And that, kids, is why we should work less. So, since working less is a heavy burden, please reject this motion.